Lesson 5. Perform under pressure. Here's a quote. People are like tea bags. You don't know their true strength until they're in hot water. Competition. Author's note. Don't worry about pressure. It's all perception. Pete Sampras did it best. When it got to 5-all in the set, most players would get tight and lose energy. But Pistol increased his energy. He believed in himself, and he thrived under that pressure situation. This is rare because not many people have that type of mindset, but anyone can think that way. You just have to decide to think that way. Ultimately, it is your perception of the situation that makes you take action, and if your perception is that you will have negative pressure, that is what you will experience. Winners and losers feel the same feelings. They just take different courses of action. It is very important to play matches. Too many people just practice. They take lessons or just hit around. You will never be match tough unless you play matches. You won't push yourself, learn, or improve. Play tournaments. Try out for a school team. Pressure situations will make you better. It will make you become more mindful of what you are doing. Harvard professor Ellen Langer developed a theory of mindfulness that I study and teach. Mindfulness is an amazing concept that I talk about later in this book. For now, just understand that to be a tennis player performing at your peak, you cannot be in an automatic or mindless state. In this way, you will be aware of and able to adjust to different conditions, opponents, have more fun, and perform better. One of the toughest things to do in sports and life is to perform well despite the presence of distractions and being under pressure. Here are some sources of pressure: winning, losing, your parents, siblings, extended family, your coaches, your teammates, your opponents, your boss, your romantic partner, your friends, referees, spectators, fatigue, and injuries. The list goes on. But the first thing you have to understand is that you will always face distractions and pressure. These stressors are a constant part of life. To overcome them, you have to commit to improving your mindset. Focus on the process. For example, how to execute your goal instead of the outcome, which is the score. This will help you feel in control, perform better, learn, and stay relaxed. It's called being intense without being tense. Another thing to remember is to focus on your breathing. Most people take short, shallow breaths when they are nervous or under pressure. When you take deep breaths, you naturally calm yourself down by feeding your muscles oxygen and releasing physical tension. Another thing to do is to put yourself in pressure situations as preparation for handling similar stress demands. If you get nervous in a tennis match, give a presentation at work. A common problem is that people try to run away from pressure situations. The truth is that it is exactly these situations that help you grow the most. The more you put yourself in those situations, the less stress you will feel and the better you will perform. It's like working out at the gym. It may be a challenge at first, but then you get used to it. However, in time, you will need to increase the level of challenge, for example, amount of weight you lift, to continue to get results. Your mind is the same way. You need to continue to push yourself in order to keep improving. So if you're a student, take a class in which the format and the level of material is more challenging than you are used to and with which you are comfortable. This works to make you a better student, because everything will be easier as you get challenged. Training your mind is just as important as training your body. Here's a quote. I am the source of all of my emotions. Nothing and no one can change how I feel except me. If I find myself in a reaction to anything, I can change it in a moment. The more you become used to and can handle pressure situations, the better player you will become. It will make the routine situations that much easier. But be careful. Many players only want to practice with those they consider better. Sure, this helps you improve. But if you only play against better players and players that hit the ball hard, guess what? When you play against someone who is a pusher or someone who doesn't hit the ball as hard and hits a lot of lobs, you will have a hard time. I frequently see high-level players who lose to lower-level players because they overhit since they are not used to generating their own pace in a match. It's better to have pressure and be nervous than to not care at all. You can be nervous and act like a champion. It's all about perception and taking action regardless of how you feel. And deep breaths always help. Christopher Longo, winner of the Meritorious Award, is a detective in Lawrence Township, New Jersey. I interviewed Detective Longo and saw the similarities between being an effective detective and performing any role in life well. We all need to be able to perform under pressure. Now, although many of us are not facing life-threatening situations, we certainly need to be on top of our games. Life throws problems at us, and sometimes many come at the same time. So, we need to be able to perform under that pressure. Detective Longo also believes that we need not only to be in shape physically, but also mentally. You cannot let your emotions get in the way of your actions. Have you ever seen great athletes walk? What do they look like? They are standing up tall, with their heads high, chests out, and shoulders back. They seem to be either floating or strutting. Don't some of them exude ultimate confidence? I'm sure some of them feel unbeatable. In order to become a great athlete, you need a confident mindset and attitude. But there is a fine line. You don't have to strut around and behave as if you're the best thing since sliced bread. But you do need to possess an unshakable inner sense of competence, confidence, and worth. Sports and life consist of self-fulfilling prophecies. If you think you can, you will. If you think you can't, you won't. That is why many top business people happen to have been former athletes. Their confidence carried over to the business world. They love challenges and look at them as part of the game. You need confidence in relationships as well. If you go around thinking you're not good enough for your mate and constantly fear that he or she is going to break up with you, guess what? It'll probably happen. This is the same for all areas of your life: finances, health, fitness, nutrition, spirituality, academics, and hobbies. There is one very important concept you need to understand about confidence. You must start acting confidently before you feel confident. You see, the problem is that most people wait until they do something great to act confidently. It doesn't work that way. The great ones acted confidently before they became successful. So how will you act? Here are some quotes on confidence. I realize that I don't have limits. Limits are always influences that come from outside, from people who don't believe in themselves and their abilities. I firmly believe in myself. I know that I can do whatever I want and that I'll always reach my goals. Madonna. Here's another quote. Whatever I did, I wanted to be the best at it. I remember that moment in The Natural when Robert Redford says, "I just want to walk down the street and have people say, 'There goes Roy Hobbs, the best there ever was.'" So I was talking to my mother one day. This is when I was 16 or 17, and she goes, "Matt, why are you so obsessed with acting?" And I said, "Because someday I want to walk down the street and have people say, 'There goes Matt Damon, the best there ever was.'" Matt Damon, actor, producer, and screenwriter. Here's a quote from Winston Churchill. "History will be kind to me, for I intend to write it." Lesson summary. Winners and losers feel the same feelings. They just take different actions.